Hello everyone, welcome to another video from Investing with the Difference. So today we are going to talk about EOS RAM again. So this has been the topmost subject in last few days, and it was actually the main discussion in today's EMLG call. So EMLG call is the call which is the mainnet block producer calls. And today Dan Larimer was there as a guest, and he answered a lot of questions. So if you missed this, and if you don't have time to watch this 1 hour 20 minutes call, so I'll go through a quick summary on what happened. So first of all, as you know, that RAM price has been going up like crazy. We did so I think this chart only shows the last 3 days. It's only showing you going from 100 EOS per megabyte to almost 400. That is 4 times in last 2 to 3 days. While if you remember, we did the first video in sometime in the week of 22nd June. And around that time, it was quoting at like less than 20 EOS per megabyte. So that means we're talking about 20 times increase. And as we are speaking, it's still going up. So people are questioning why block. So there are two kind of people, right? So some who are really speculating on RAM and they are making money on this. There is another set of people who are not happy that why the RAM prices are going up, it is not good for the EOS. So we are going to talk about few things here. And just to quote Dan, so I think what he was recommending is that there is no problem with what is happening, and any solution like doubling the RAM right away or anything which you change will not really fix this problem. The reason why it will not fix is this is driven by speculators. So right now, the only the amount of EOS which has been used for this speculation is 5 million EOS, as you can see here. And this has this is very small portion. It's like 0.5% of the total EOS. So the speculators can keep piling up RAM. Even if you have like more RAM, they can keep piling up and this curve will just get stretched. So let me explain you. Right now, so let's say if you have this kind of a curve, which is RAM is on this side and the price which is going up. So excuse me for my bad mouse, but let me say this is the price. Now the price is how the Bancor algorithm works. It will always be an exponential curve. Now at some point, speculators will make a decision that it's now the very small amount of RAM is costing you so much, and they will start dumping the RAM. And this is where it becomes a matter of who is holding and how much you have the holding capacity, and it can crash. So this is the same as what happened with Bitcoin. So if you know, let's say this is the Bitcoin chart. So again, just like RAM is limited, 64 gig, Bitcoins are like 21 million Bitcoins, which can happen. There's a theory of why Bitcoin will go all the way up to 500K. Some people talk about $1 million. But similarly, so whether this is 64 gig or it is 128, doesn't matter. Because what will happen is the price which is going to be paid in the end for very, very small RAM will be very high. So what I'm trying to highlight is this can keep going up, but no, now it's about you are at this exponential stage, and you don't know at what stage the speculators will give up or start. Like I showed you a video a few days back that one whale, he dumped 1 gig of RAM and he brought it down the price by almost 20 to 30% in one go. And now anybody who is holding such a huge RAM, who is sitting on 20 times the profit, he can bring down the prices even higher because we are on the higher end of this exponential curve. So I hope that I communicated this clearly, that the size of the RAM doesn't matter. It has the same result, that ultimately the speculators will take it all the way up. At some point, they will start dumping. And the people who join late, this is what happens with every speculative market, they get crushed because right now you are doubling your money every day, and the small investors, who don't really understand what is going on, they come in pretty late. Now, why adding more RAM will not help is because ultimately, right now, if you think that RAM will become 100%, it's impossible, because Bancor algorithm will make sure that the next 10% increase in RAM utilization will lead to almost 4 times or 5 times the price, or maybe 10 times the price. And you will, at some point, the EOS will run out. And when it goes close to 100%, it will become infinite. So it will be almost impossible to buy RAM. So the worry which people have is, what if the DApp developers are not able to afford it? And that is where I think Dan is suggesting that at some point you have to define some rules of how you're going to add RAM. He's suggesting something like 20% per year, and there has to be a model. Because right now, if you just add RAM, it will just create additional supply and speculators will keep running with it. Now, the long-term solution is that side chains will be made available, and they will have another 64 gig of RAM, and they can they will keep multiplying available RAM for DApps, and that way there will be infinite supply of RAM. So in general, I think these kind of things were discussed. There is no short-term solution, and a very, very good point which Dan raised was, we don't want DApps to have cheap RAM, because ultimately you want RAM optimized applications. And second thing is, it's only the entry cost. When you do a RAM, like when you need a RAM for DApp or account creation, that's only one-time cost. After that, if you do 10 transactions or 20 transactions, you already pay for your account, because on any other network, right now you're paying fees, which is not going to be the case for EOS. So it's not a problem, even if you have to start with an account which is expensive. And this speculation has to take care of itself at some point, where it will come down whenever it's a technical nature. Just like Bitcoin came back from $20,000 to $6,000, at some point this will come down when people don't see any benefits of speculating, or when they start seeing losses. And that can happen anytime when some big guy dumps, or at some point when the price rise is not happening fast enough, and people realize that this is the end of the game. So I think this is going to be a very, very interesting take. If you are a speculator, nobody knows. If you ask me how high it can go any amount. It can go to 1,000 EOS. It can go to 10,000 EOS per megabyte. There is no limit, because right now we are at 80% utilization. So if you remember, when we were at 60%, we were like below 100 EOS. That is like 4 times it has gone up. Now we are talking about another 10% that can actually take it to another maybe 4 times. So that is how it will work. And I don't think there's any quick fix happening. If you have a reason to keep speculating, you can do that, knowing that it can come down, just like any speculative market can come down at any time. So this is the summary of what is happening. Overall, I don't think there is any quick fix. Dan talked about technical issues, that the reason people are really taking the price up today is because there was a lot of discussion in this YouTube video where Dan explained that it is not going to be technically easy for block producers to add the RAM, and every block producer has to add the RAM to make this possible. And the sidechain solution is not ready right now. It's going to take another few months. And this is why at this moment, the only way it can resolve itself is that this scrum comes down when people start losing money. And that is where it will stabilize. So if you are a DApp developer, I think it's not a great situation, because of course you have to spend more money. Airdrops are getting stopped because of this. Most of the DApp developers who are already working on it, I hope that they have already taken some position in RAM. They're not waiting, because they already know how much time they need. And at some point, in fact, they will start releasing when they realize they don't need the amount they bought. And they can also bring the price down. But if somebody who's new and who's starting to develop on a DApp, I think this will be a challenge. We understand that. And this is something which block producers have to work on and decide how it will be resolved. So this is the summary. Please send us your questions, comments about what you think. If you're speculating on RAM, be very careful. We think now it is a lottery. It is not really a good investment because now it's become more of a gamble. At what point it will start crashing. If you're lucky and you bought earlier and you held on to it, I think you made 20 times your EOS tokens, which was the possibility here. And a lot of whales have done this, people who understand this, people who are experienced in speculating. So that's where we stand on EOS RAM. I think now we think it's a time to exit if you already own it. The risk reward is not in the favor, but I think this is going to continue because of the craze, because anybody, if you go to the Telegram channel of EOS RAM trading, people don't even understand what is happening. They're talking about, oh, it will go to 100%. Let me explain you once again, it can never go to 100% utilization. The price can definitely go 10 times more high without even touching close to 100%, because that's how a resource which is scarce, that is how it is priced. That is the same theory why people invest in Bitcoin at this stage, because it is scarce, it is only limited amount of Bitcoin which are there. And it doesn't matter at what point you you set up your supply, it always manages to reach that peak based on demand, not based on supply. So it all depends on how many EOS are there which are willing to bet, and not depends on how much RAM is added by block producers. So I hope this clarifies people who are questioning block producers or EOS of why they are not adding. I don't think that's going to solve the problem. So that's all from now. I hope it answers some of your questions. I didn't intend to make such a long video, but I think this is necessary for you to understand before you speculate. And we will do more sessions to explain you what's going on in EOS world. So thanks for joining. Please subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Bye for now. Thank you.